imagine your hands being so sore that you couldn't wash the dishes, couldn't drive a car, couldn't throw a tennis ball to your child, or when it gets really bad, couldn't even hold your partner's hand. Well, mechanic of 27 years, Chris Booth, doesn't have to imagine. For the past 2 years, he hasn't been able to work. He says he's lived with hand-arm vibration syndrome, a rare condition similar to carpal tunnel brought on by prolonged exposure to vibration. Matt Chisholm in the Hawke's Bay with a man who says he lives with constant pain, a man who says no one is listening to his cries for help.
Numbness, tingliness in the fingers.
They're fat, white and cold. It's like taking an ice block out of the freezer and putting it against your cheek.
Discoloration and the swelling.
Oh, hang on, hang on.
Buttons I find the hardest.
No, you're going to have to do that up, mate.
Yeah.
Is that all right?
Yeah, because I haven't been this for a day.
I can't hold hands with them for too long.
It's like a field of numbness around the hands.
Chris Booth says he's crippled by something you simply can't see.
As far as holding anything up with my wrist, like the jug or a bottle of milk or anything like that, I have to use two hands.
When he normally works in the garage, receiving things, his hands get a little bit swayed.
Chris is convinced he's got hand-arm vibration syndrome, a rare condition brought on by prolonged exposure to vibration.
Every time I go to do something with my hands, I feel pain. If you put it on a scale from 1 to 10, on a really bad day, I'd have to say it'd be a 9. It's like having an ache all day, every day. I can't wash dishes, and it's just too hard. The next day, my hands are just completely swollen. It's pretty much brought me to a halt in everything that I do in my life.
For 18 months, he's been fighting ACC for compensation without success, and it's left this family in crisis.
I've actually thought that they'd be better off without me.
I feel like I'm on the go all the time, and it's just really wearing myself out.
His nightmare began 2 years ago when he was a motorcycle mechanic.
Well, it basically came on over a period of about a week and a half. I noticed that my wrist joint was getting tighter and tighter and tighter over that period, to a point where my hands were completely swollen and I couldn't move my wrists.
To your mind, exactly what caused this condition?
I'd have to put it down to rattle gun. Started operating a rattle gun in January, went through to August. That's when I started having the symptoms.
Chris would hit the trigger on his vibrating rattle gun at least 100 times a day, servicing just two motorbikes. Some days he would service eight.
And that's what they're designed to do, is to impact nuts off. It's a living nightmare, having to deal with this on a day-to-day basis.
His whole demeanour is just totally different from when he goes out to work.
Spending just a few hours with Chris, it's difficult to know whether he lives with pain or not, whether he has the hand-arm vibration syndrome he claims he has.
I sort of think of your hands almost like a back problem, in that I can look at you and it's hard for me to really see that you have a condition.
Yeah.
Are you a hypochondriac?
Absolutely not.
Do you want to work?
Absolutely. I'm not one for sitting around doing nothing. I'm a go-forward person. Always have been, always will.
What can you say or do to convince us that you have this condition?
It's very easy for people to see me through the day doing some normal things that other people do. What they don't see is the impact that it has on my hands. And the other reason is because nobody understands the disease.
While Chris's specialist believes he has a vibration-induced injury, ACC have rejected his claims, which has left him on an invalid's benefit.
We've always had to go through the WIMS for extra help with the daily financials and stuff, and that's something Chris and I, we don't really like doing.
ACC have accepted just 7 claims for the syndrome in the past 5 years.
Around the corner here, mate.
Whereas in the UK, there is an estimated 228,000 sufferers.
Could you grab that for me, mate, and put it through the hole?
I wish they would just open their eyes up and have some sympathy for people who actually go through this. Because it is really hard. It has been really, really hard on us.
Love you heaps.
Love you. All right.
Be good. I'm pretty disgusted with the system that we have here. I've serviced an industry for 27 years. I've paid my ACC levies. And I get nothing. How would you feel?
ACC wouldn't appear in our story and would not even answer specific questions about Chris's claim because they say it's now under independent review.